Last year, Yul Kwon became the first Asian-American champion on Survivor. He's the son of South Korean immigrants, and by the time he auditioned for Survivor, he'd earned degrees from Stanford and Yale. We talked recently. You went to school to be an attorney. What kind of pressure is there in many Asian-American communities to go to law school, to be a doctor, to become sort of a traditional profession like that?
There's a huge amount of pressure. In my case, actually, I didn't go to school to become a lawyer initially. My dad wanted me to get a PhD in something really hard, like math or physics. And he was actually very disappointed when I didn't go for that and went to law school
instead. Are you serious? He was disappointed when he became a lawyer?
Yeah, wow. No, you know, my parents came from a very different culture. So they came, they grew up in the aftermath of the Korean War. Mm-hmm. And for them, academics was a key to getting out of poverty and to having success. Mm-hmm. So when they immigrated to this country, you know, they basically wanted me and my brother to study all the time. I think my parents were concerned to some extent that we might face discrimination in this country. So they didn't want us to pursue a career path where our success would be dictated by our social skills. Mm-hmm. They wanted us to do something where we could produce objective, quantifiable results like science or engineering.
How did your parents, and many parents from that generation, define success?
I think success is defined monetarily, but in a lot of Asian cultures, social status is also very key.
And what sort of professions were taboo?
Well, you know, my parents always taught me that smart kids got PhDs and became professors, dumb kids dropped out of school and became politicians, or worse yet, actors. So in my case, you know, when I went to law school and told them I wanted to get involved in political activism, they're mortified. And when I told them I was going to go on a reality show, my dad almost had a heart attack.
Now that you've won Survivor, does he feel differently?
He does. I mean, he was concerned because he thought I was throwing away my career and all the schooling. He didn't understand why he would come to this country to give opportunities for me and my brother and had flushed it down the toilet. But I think for my father, you know, seeing me on the show and seeing what kind of person I was and seeing a side of me that he hadn't seen before when I was growing up really opened his eyes. And so it's really brought us closer together.
How do you carry forward the sort of the values that you were raised with? I mean, when you have a child, will you want them to be a lawyer or to be a doctor?
I think, you know, my parents wanted the best for us, right? So, but what I try to remind them is that they're living in a different world now. We're not living in this other society where your success would be guaranteed if you did well in school. In this country, I mean, it's important to study hard and to have academics, but how far you get in life often depends on the connections that you have, the relationships you have with people. And that's why, you know, a lot of Asian Americans hit the glass ceiling, because they focus on their functional areas, but they don't develop the broader network they need to get ahead.
You talked when you were on Survivor about trying to be out in the public eye to kind of change stereotypes of Asian Americans.
Right.
What do you think those stereotypes are?
I think the perception is that Asian Americans, especially Asian American men, are math geeks. They lack social skills, they lack leadership skills. Either that or they're kung fu masters, you know, who could kick butt, but they can't speak English.
Mm. And how do you go about changing that?
Well, I think the way to change it is to show people that you're an individual, and that's why I went on a reality show. The great thing about a reality show is that, unlike scripted shows, you know, even though you might be cast as a stereotype, in which case I think I was, you don't have to act according to a script. You can be whoever you want. You can show people that you can be smart and athletic and be articulate all at the same time.
It's got to be really devastating. I mean, it's got to be really tough to just be a normal Asian American kid growing up with these kind of heavy burdens placed on you.
Yeah, absolutely. I think because of the model minority myth, a lot of kids feel that they have to live up to a standard that's very difficult to actually obtain. And so it's exactly the dilemma that I think a lot of kids face, which is like, hey, I'm supposed to be smart. Everyone expects me to be smart. But if I'm not doing well in school, then what am I?
Yul Kwon, it's fascinating. Appreciate you being on the program.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks.